Okay, viewers, well, I did this battery charger test after I made the video, and it all works fine. I just gotta put some, bend these clips up behind the switch so it holds in tightly, and tape around the electrical connections here for extra safety. The switch could end up popping out one day, by the way, because it gets used often. If it doesn't get treated right, or if they're not careful, the switch could get popped out and these live connections would get hit to the earth, so not a good thing. Make it so you can't. There you go. Make it so it clips in really good. We gotta straighten this out, all this bent stuff. I don't know what happened there, something landed on it, smashed there and it smashed it all in. It's twisted all this and bent all down the bottom. Something heavy must have fallen on it. Try and get this dent to clean, straighten up. There you go, fixed. Can't get it perfectly straight, but it's a lot better than what it was. I'll have to bend down. Alright, I'll put some tape and stuff around this switch. Maybe put a bit of a little tiny dab of super glue to lock it in, so it's not so wobbly. And around this too, so it locks it in. Put some tape around these connections here. And yeah. Should be fixed, so let's get repairing. Okay, we'll just put a little bit of super glue on the edges there to hold the components in place so they don't end up falling in. That's pretty damn good now. Switch didn't get anything in the rocker. If that rocker got super glue, I'd be pissed. And the switch would be stuck closed. Then I'd be real pissed, but yeah. Yeah, all this thing needs now is a little bit of TLC, and I just put it back together and give it a test. I did test it yesterday off camera. Didn't bother filming it, but I did charge a battery alright, so let's get this back together. Yeah, just had a hard life. Something's fallen up there and smashed it in. Scraped a nice scratch mark on it. That's what it's supposed to look like there, like that. You carry it by the handle there. And that's where you wind your leads on. Yeah, let's put this thing back together. She's fixed. Let me give her a test. Okay, viewers, well, she's reasonably straight. A little bit bent here, though. So, it's a finished product. Let's give her a test. But if we haven't got any bad connections in there in my soldering, so let's give her a check out. She should work now. Alright, let's plug that in. Power cord here. I'm actually not touching anything. Switch you off to start off with. I'll switch you on actually. There you go, she works. Circuit breaker's there. Nice hum too. Alright, let's charge a battery and see how she goes. Okay, viewers, time for a charge test. Obviously, never on 24 volt unless you want to blow it up, that'd be dangerous. Make sure on 12 volt and on charge. I'm not really sure what this circuit breaker was for, but yeah, there must be two main circuit breakers here. Or there anyway. Yeah, let's get this cranked out battery a charge. This battery's been cranked out, so no more desulfating or using this battery again. I got another one of these, from the early 90s. I've had it dried out for a while. I cut it open and show you the insides, what happens when they run out of cranking power. Okay, I'll start with off, turn it on. 12 volt, it's on high. We'll start with low actually. Charge, output's on. Yeah. Obviously a battery that's going to give you false readings obviously, but that actually works. High current charging. Yeah, flat charging, so it's getting there, so it's about midway at the moment. And that's the pilot lamp, that's saying it's 240 volt going to it, circuit breaker. Yeah, 24 volt through a 12 volt battery. Put that wire over there, a couple of meters away. There's my long leads. That's when you'll use 24 volt to blow it up, but that's too dangerous. You need a lot of safety precautions if you want to blow up one of them, so I don't recommend doing that. Very dangerous. But anyway, let this battery charge. And obviously the needle's going to go point to fully charged. The battery's fully charged, but it's obviously going to give you false readings being cranked out and old and weak. But yeah, she's doing a good job. I can't get that dent perfect there, but yeah, she works. Neutral position. So obviously when the battery's flat, this actually moves this way. When there's no power to it, the fault position's here, but yeah, output's off. I'm not sure what engine I could start with this. Let's see. Did it repeat? Okay, I had an engine start. Connect battery charger to the battery and vehicle connection procedure. So if you've got a positive and a negative, just connect it like that as if you're jump starting. Or you go negative to the chassis, depending on which type of car it is. Some cars are positive earthed. There you go, something I never knew. So you connect negative to the chassis and a positive to your battery. Then what you'll do, set the battery voltage to 12 volt if it's a vehicle that's 12 volt, which is most commonly. Then the power switch and switch on the output. Turn on the mains. Turn car's ignition key to start engine. If the engine fails to start after 3 seconds, wait 10 seconds before retrying again. Note, do not repeat this operation more than 10 times. If the engine has started, switch off 240 volt, turn this off and switch off, and yeah. Obviously it's going to put voltage to here from the alternator. If the engine fails to start, contact a mechanic or auto electrician. Troubleshooting. If battery fails to charge or hold charge, it is likely that the battery is defective. Consult your local dealer. Oh, no shit. Pretty obvious stuff. So that circuit board in here that I fixed up that was all burnt. Obviously, if you crank it longer than what it says here, that would have been the result. Just burnt it out. I can imagine this transformer in here would get bloody hot cranking an engine that amount of time. But yeah, she's working pretty good. There you go. It's all fixed, so thanks for watching.